Welcome to night two of the Down Home Takeover, ETSU Bluegrass, Old Time and Roots Music. These are the end of the semester performances that we do. I'm Dan Boner, I'm the director of the program, and we have several faculty who are here tonight that you're going to get to know. And we have to always begin by thanking Ed Snodderly and Keegan and Reva and those who are working here at the Down Home tonight. They deserve a big hand for all the running around for you all. We've been coming here for a lot of years. How many people were here last night, I wonder? Okay, so a pretty new audience here. We had a really good concert last night. It was streamed live on Facebook, and we're streaming live tonight, so say hello to all of our Facebook friends out here tonight. Up here on the guitar, she's a multi-instrumentalist, because we usually see her with a fiddle, but she's been here now for a few in the Appalachian Studies Master's Program. She earned that degree. And she's also been performing with a professional band called Bill and the Bells. She is one of the bells, I presume.
Some days.
Some days. And it's funny, no one is named Bill in that group, right? It's Chris Trulson and others. Oh, that's a secret. But she's doing a great job. She's a lecturer of old time music here. This is Ms. Kalia Yeagle.
Sing me a song, though I call to the end of my journey.
guys. I just wanted to introduce us again. We're the Runaway String Band. I also wanted to say this semester we've been working on a lot from Olabelle Reed and the Coon Creek Girls specifically, and the last song we sang was Sing Me a Song by Olabelle Reed. And she actually wrote that song, which is pretty cool because she wrote most of her songs, not all of them. But it was really cool to see an old-time writer write her songs and perform them. So hope you enjoy the rest of our tunes.
Yeah. Where's your next?
Circumstances, we have two members that couldn't be here today, so we are doing our darndest, just the three of us, but we want to definitely but this next song was one we all decided we really like and definitely wanted to perform, but usually it's Caitlin, our dear friend Caitlin, who sings it and really sings the heck out of it too, but she needed to be at a rehearsal today with the music department, which we respect, very important show she's gearing up for. But we'll definitely send this one out to Caitlin, and we're going to call in some reinforcements from our friend and my colleague, Roy Andrade, who's going to join us on the banjo. And our other bandmate, Bailey. Bailey's home real sick right now. Wishing her well. Hope she feels better soon. We're missing her harmonies. Her guitar playing. All right. But here's our rendition, tonight's Runaway String Band, our rendition of Olabelle Reed's I've Endured.
Thank you.
picking everybody. That old Bill Reed song reminds me of growing up. I grew up in southern New Jersey, South Jersey. And about an hour away was where Olabel and David and all of them lived. Come on up, guys. Oh, when they're done. And the second group I ever played in when I was 11 years old was the Strings of Gospel. And David Reed, Olabel's son, played banjo in that band. And that was right about the time when High on the Mountain had won a gold record for Marty Stewart. So that was a real big thing for the family. And Olabel was just a lovely lady. She was a God-fearing woman and from Lansing, North Carolina. Wonderful folks. So a lot of memories there. So good job, everybody. All right. This is Mr. Jason Leek's group, and it seems like he's not here tonight, or is he hiding? Sometimes he hides and doesn't let us know he's here because he doesn't want me to point him out. But maybe he's watching on Facebook. But so tell us the name of your group, and then have at it. What do you call yourselves?
We haven't got that far yet, I guess.
You're going to make me get my phone out and look at the list. You had a very clever leak. I'm reading as I speak.
A clever leak. I don't know how I feel about that.
It's just called the Leek Bluegrass Band. So make them feel good. The Leek Bluegrass Band.
As of right now,
that was decided just now. No, we're here for that. We're gonna feature the banjo player over here on one. Mr. Wilbur, give it up for him. Thank you. just a little bit of switching around here. Going to feature our bass player, and I guess technically right now mandolin player on this one. Give it up for Mr. Logan Grindle.
Yeah.
Albert the Australian and John the Irishman. Me and Bill from Britain, mad dogs in the sun. Matterhorn, Matterhorn. Men have tried and men have died to find the Matterhorn. That mighty Matterhorn. Lost John and the rations fell below. Al and Bill were lying beneath an avalanche of snow. Now here I am, all alone, and I know I cannot stop. Two more yards in front of me before I reach the top. Matterhorn, Matterhorn. Men have tried and men have died. Get back down. It's closer here to heaven than it is back to the ground. Matterhorn, Matterhorn. Men have tried and men have died to climb the Matterhorn. That mighty Matterhorn. That mighty.
He's not really a multi-instrumentalist, but he is definitely a dual instrumentalist. I'm just kidding, he can play about anything, play guitar, banjo. I forget, you're mainly a banjo player, Logan.
Oh, yeah.
That's a great job. And
just whatever needs to be played.
Yeah, that's right. We're going to feature our current mandolin player. We're still looking for a new one. This is Tyler Chatted back here. We're going to feature him on a song called House of Gold.
Better watch yourself, we'll be looking for a guitar player.
Yeah.
I didn't mean that serious. I shouldn't say that before a gospel. They cheat and lie. The other guitar player back here, arguably the prettiest member of the group, I guess. And I'm not talking about Lauren. And anyway, she's gonna come sing one for y'all. I'm sure she grew up in this music a lot, being from the deep south of Minnesota.
Yep.
Yeah. So, anyway, she does a great job singing, so we're gonna have her sing one. Miss Addie Moss.
I'm not afraid.
to introduce the guitar player, though. That's Mr. Will Hart, doing a good job on the singing and playing. So, yeah, thank y'all for having us, and I hope y'all enjoy the rest of the band.
Our recent alumni has been recruited to help teach. Mr. Troy Boone is over there somewhere. Maybe if you cheer for him, he'll come on up. Where's he at?
He's coming.
Is he? Troy's been working hard on some recording projects. He's built a recording studio. He's got a new youngin, relatively new wife, new job, new car, don't you even? You had to get a new car after that accident, right?
Are you stalking me, Dan?
I need to know about my people. Tell us about this group. You had several good groups last night, and you've got another group or two this evening.
Absolutely. So, take this off so y'all can hear me, and my glasses are quit fogging it. But yeah, this group, we just like the others, we hit this semester head on earlier in the fall, and they first practice they said, I said, what do you guys want to be called? And they were like, well, we don't have a fiddle, so how about no fiddling around? And that was inevitably what they decided on. And, I gotta say, I didn't know what to expect, but each of them brought each one of these songs, and we've had several trials. Our guitar player, Philip, was originally our bass player, and he broke his arm skateboarding halfway through the semester. And when he had his cast on, I came into rehearsal, and I was talking to Nate and everybody about what we were gonna do, and Jason had the bass, and Philip had the guitar, and they were just jamming. And Philip had that guitar like this because he had a cast on. And I was like, can you play like that? And he was like, I guess so. And I was like, all right, you're hired. So.
Is there a really cool video on YouTube with like 8 million views of this accident you had?
No, unfortunately not.
Wasn't nearly that spectacular?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, it was. It stressed me out. But it ended up working out. And I think what they prepared you guys will enjoy. So, if you all are ready to roll.
They're all down on that end.
I know, it's like they're scared of us.
They're trying to get away from me. That's the thing.
If only we could, Jason. If only we could.
Oil and water or something. All right, so they are No Fiddling Around. Please put your hands together for No Fiddling Around.
My name's Wicked, I'm a big show.
Who's excited to see live music finally again? Yeah! So thank you all for coming out tonight to see the Down Home. We're no fiddling around, and we're so happy to be playing for you guys. Right there on the banjo, he's from the great city of Chicago, Illinois. And I think he tore the banjo up on that song. Please give him a hand for Mr. Joe Cangelosi. So this next song, waiting for the banjo to tune up.
As always.
How many, raise your hand, how many of you are somehow related to ETSU? You're in the program, Appalachian Studies, go to school there? Good, good. How many of you, is the first time seeing one of ETSU's bands? We got a couple, good. Thank you for coming out. We really appreciate it. We love playing for you guys. We hope you enjoy some of our tunes. So this next, getting tuned up, buddy?
No, I'm good.
So this next song, I'm gonna send out to all my friends from West Virginia. Woo! From the girl. Oh, we got a couple West Virginia folks here.
It was just me, Jason. I'm
sorry. Oh, okay. Can we give a hand to our director of the band, Mr. Troy Boone? He did a great job. So, I will actually send this out to all the girls from West Virginia. I don't know a lot of girls.
You got your mom.
I do got my mom, that's correct. I do got my mom. But, all jokes aside, this is one of Doyle Lawson's most famous hits, and we're going to miss him retiring at the end of this year, but we hope you'll enjoy this song. This song is called The Girl from West Virginia. The show must go on, folks. Keep going. He's from Virginia. Please give a hand to Mr. Philip Davidson. Yeah. now it's going time to get to the sacred side of the show. We're going to do Wayfaring Stranger.
All right.
Performing again, being a year, almost 2 years out not playing, I missed it. great seeing you. So give yourself a round of applause, guys. Without you, we would be great. Joe has something to say now.
Without further ado, we're going to do, can't talk, introduce Jason Gaynor, our own girl from West Virginia.
I'm sure we're all wondering, but I don't think we want to know what you did to get Hugh Hefner's coat.
But without further ado, we're going to play one more song for y'all.
And again, thank you. Before we end, Mr. Joe Cangelosi on the banjo, Philip Davidson on the guitar, Ben Garber on the mandolin. My name is Jason Gaynor. Thank you. And we're going to end it out with Dr. Ralph Stanley's favorite hit, Clinch Mountain Step, Backstep. And there might even be a special surprise there, so you're going to have to wait and see. Again, thank you all. Have a good night. Hear the Clinch Mountain Backstep.
Students who, even while they're students, they're making an impact on our music. I'm thinking about Mr. Jacob Metz, who's right up there at the soundboard helping run sound tonight. He plays dobro and banjo with Darren and Brooke Aldridge. He's played on the Grand Ole Opry a few times already, and he's going to be graduating in just about a week. So, and also, lady who's making her way to the stage with Kalia tonight, she won. She placed fifth at the National Fiddle Championship at Weezer, Idaho, just a few years ago. Miss Ashley Dreyer here and Kalia, they're going to come on up and do a number together. So make them feel welcome, if you would. Kalia and Ashley.
We have one quick one. We hope you enjoy.
and I'm still waiting.
Nice duets and trios to bring
Ashley
to her group.
Found that one.
Did Ashley?
Yeah.
Where did that one come from?
That's from the Davis Sisters.
Now that's a cool group to check out. The Davis Sisters.
Not actually sisters.
That's
fun fact.
Part of the fun facts that you'll learn at ETSU if you come here. So. Good job, guys. We have a brand new artist in residence. We have two artists in residence. If you tuned in last night or you were here last night, you got to hear Brittany Haas, who is here this evening. Brittany directs a couple of old-time band and a progressive bluegrass band, I believe. And they did an exceptional job. And then tonight we have another gentleman who is very well known in the bluegrass and old-time music world and Americana and roots. He's from down in Mississippi. Nails and axle grease on his clothes. But they are very nice clothes. It's Mr. Mike Compton over there. Mike's a Grammy Award-winning mandolin player. And we're so fortunate that the university has supported our program through the years. I'm sure Roy Andrade can remember the days when we make and living your life as an artist. We have such a diverse faculty. I see Dr. Lee Bidgood down here with his offspring. His man child is wearing a hat, just like his good old dad. we got Nate Olson back here in the back. I saw Roy and Brittany. Trying to see if there's any other of our faculty here tonight. If not, you'll see them the rest of the week. Do you guys want to play a set?
Yeah.
All right.
That was a pretty good stretch you did there.
Not my first rodeo. Not my first down-home show. We enjoyed you and Joe Newberry the other night here, Mike. Those folks who were here got to see Mike and Joe perform.
You're very kind.
No, rhythmically, y'all need to watch this man's rhythm. He can just take the whole group on a ride wherever he feels like putting the beat and the offbeat and all those in between notes. It just creates a groove, and
Stop.
Do you need hand warmers? Or do you
I
need,
do. Yep.
I breathe in your hands and help, but it's COVID, you know. So.
Look at that.
We need.
You had to say that.
What do you need?
We broke the bass, Mike.
That right there. That's what we need.
Okay.
We'll just do one.
Just one?
Yeah.
Okay, turn off the others.
Let's just do this one.
We might use that one.
We're used to that. Are you going to do that now?
You're playing the fiddle now, aren't you?
You changed your mind.
Yes.
Go, go, go.
It just gets better from here. They've changed the name on me. They've changed the name on me before we even got up here.
You're still Mike, aren't you?
I'm, yeah. This bashful Brother Metz over there. Cousin Connor in the background. And the flower of Idaho. Ashley Dreyer.
That's not Martha White flower, though, is it?
No,
Ashley Dreyer.
That ain't a growing flower. That ain't an eating flower, it's a growing flower. I wish I'd made that.
Can I leave the stage yet?
I wish you would.
Alright. Mike Knopfler, everybody.
We started out as the Texas Hillbillies, and I believe now it's. You say, I'm afraid I'd mess up if I say it.
We are the Texas Throttlers.
Thank you.
it's brought to the table from unknown origins. We don't know what it's called or where it's from. Well, we know what it's called. It's called Lonesome Train, right?
It is that.
Lonesome Train Waltz. But he said his dad learned it out of a Mel Bay book or something like that. We don't know where it's from. Our theme this kind of semester has been mostly around Texas old-time music, and we're about to do a Texas number called Terrell, Texas Blues from Doc and Oscar. Is it Doc and Oscar Harper?
Man, I don't know.
I think it might be. anyway, that first one we did was Fire in the Mountain, and I think that was from the Redheaded Fiddlers. And this kind of band was based on this collection called the Texas Hillbillies. It was put out by David Bragger a few years ago. And it's really great. And you should check it out. I think it's all on Spotify.
Well,
that's the end of my MC work.
Right, y'all ready?
Yes, Mike.
Where are we all going? Okay.
I'm trying to figure out where we're going.
I don't know where I'm going.
It's okay.
One, two, three, four. Bragger's Texas Hillbillies collection. If you're into that good old Texas style groove,
that's awesome.
No, I have to. Well, yeah. I should have not talked.
Yeah, that was kind of foolish of us. We're going to get one that comes from the Farr Brothers that Mike introduced us to, and this has nothing to do with Texas, I don't think, unless Roy Rogers is from Texas.
Well, it's been done by a lot of different people over the years.
Yeah, you talk about it.
Well, I don't know that much about it. I used to play this with David Greer a little bit. He liked this one real well. And it was one of the slower ones, moving ones that we played together. After hearing Ashley play a little bit, I thought, well, I bet she could just play the fire out of this tune if I could find it. I had to look for it. But there's a bunch of people that have done this before. This has got a little bit different flavor to it, and she took to it like a duck to water. And
like a flower in Idaho.
Whatever you say. Anyway, this is the old Madeira waltz.
To us and said, I just feel as though this piece is impossible to play because of the way that it sounds, and we kind of decided that that's what's happening. Jacob Metz also over here used a flat pick on a 5-string banjo. I'm kind of thinking that's nice. And I like that.
Also, just a round of applause for Metz on the claw, everybody.
Two-step. I think we're about ready to play.
different than the Green Apple two-step.
It's very different.
Okay.
You'll see why.
I'm ready for a nap.
Thank you.
hungry, man. That was awesome. Give them another hand for that. See, you don't need an upright bass for everything, right? I mean,
I didn't even notice they didn't have a bass.
You didn't?
I really did.
I had the feel, man.
That was killer. Yeah. I just want everybody to know that Jacob came to me and said, "Hey, man, can I use your pick?" And I was like, "Man, I don't have banjo picks." And he grabbed my blue chip, and I was like, "I don't know what I'm about to watch up here." But
so he just played with a flat pick?
He did. It was incredible.
I thought he was claw hammering, or
he did. Playing. It was both. He did both.
So it was like chicken picking or something with the banjo?
Yeah. I don't know what you'd call it. Flat clawing.
Flat clawing.
Did he just create a style of banjo at the downhill? I think he did.
Okay. Great job, Jacob. Where you at, Jacob? Would you like to explain what it was? Cricket. Okay, so he must be in the back room. Troy, what are you doing up here?
I'm just waiting on my guys to get up here.
They're just standing there. Like,
everybody's afraid of me and you tonight, Dan. I don't know what it is.
Well, it comes with the territory. But it really does. I mean, everybody said it. I don't mean it to be cliche, but it sure does feel good to see an audience. In the last several times we were here at the Down Home, with student performances, we played the cameras, and we had multicam set up so that way people on Facebook could watch, and that was making the best out of a bad situation. It's nice to see people again. I really do like that. Jacob, while they're getting plugged in, so we're calling your style of banjo playing, what was it, flat claw?
Flat clawing.
Flat clawing.
Works for me.
So tell us how you did that. Come up here. Come up here. So how did you do it? Show like the technique. This is educational here, everybody.
A G chord.
So you're just strumming?
I gotta see if I can do that. Close. It sounded right to me. I don't know.
What's the name of your band? Do they have a name?
Yes.
All right.
This is Wild Posse. They inherited it. I don't know. I asked Nate what the name of the band was, and he told me. So here we are. What you gonna sing? Just tell him what you're going to say.
Sorry. So I guess ventriloquism is not my thing. I really was going for it. We're going to do a song by, that I first heard by my favorite artist, Merle Haggard, but a lot of bluegrass people apparently do this song. So it's going to be called California Cotton Fields, and I hope you guys enjoy it. One night I heard my daddy saying to my mom that he finally saved enough gold. California was his dream, paradise it seemed. Pictures and magazines that told him so. California cotton fields, where labor camps were filled with weary men with broken dreams. California cotton fields, as close to wealth my daddy ever came. I recall
and a chain of luck were just 4 days away. But the only chains that I remember seeing for my daddy, in the dark, you're turning somewhere. California cotton fields, and our hearts were filled with weary men with broken dreams. California cotton fields, as close to wealth my daddy ever came. As close to wealth my daddy ever came.
But I just wanted to keep you guys on your toes. That's all.
You were looking like the lyrics were over yonder somewhere.
You know, I thought they were on the wall over there, but it's a little bit too blurry for me. I posted them up there earlier.
Must be all that velvet you're wearing.
That definitely is the velvet.
Tell them who your banjo picker is.
And this guy over here, his name's Caleb Dion, so give it up for Caleb.
Yeah!
He made me say his name right. I called him Kyle one time and I can't stop, but he made me call him Caleb today, so.
You got it right. That's
I did get it right, so.
The fiddle tune?
Yeah.
Why don't you tell him about it a little bit?
Yeah, go ahead.
Well, this is one of my favorite fiddle tunes. I've been playing it for almost as long as I've been playing the banjo. It's one I played this one with my brother a lot back home. And this is a fiddle tune called Whiskey Before Breakfast.
Song is a song that I heard in a movie one time. I watched live lick on this guy named Blaze Foley, and I heard this song, but it's, it got popularized by a guy named John Prine, and it's called Clay Pigeons, and I hope you guys enjoy it. I'm going down to the Greyhound station, gonna get a ticket to ride. Gonna find that lady or two with her kids and sit down by her side. Ride till the sun comes up and down, run about two or three times. Smoke the cigarettes in the last seat. Try to hide my sorrow from the people I meet, get along with it all. Where you people say y'all, sing a song with a friend, change the shape that I'm in, get back in the game and start playing again. I like to say, but I might have to go to start over again. I could go down to Texas, might go to somewhere I've never been. Days and the nights that it takes to get back in the saddle again. Feed the pigeons some clay. Turn the night into day. Start talking again when I know what to say. Spot for the movie, because I went back and I found it again. I had to learn how to do what that was.
Yeah, I gotta say, we were in practice one day, and these guys are goofballs, as you can tell. but it's been an absolute blast every time we rehearse. And I came into the lounge or the rehearsal room one day, and Adrian was playing that just by himself, and I was like, man, I don't know why you want to play bluegrass, because that's what you should be doing. But I think he's doing a great job.
This is one of my first times really playing bluegrass, and I tell you, I'm getting more into it as I go. As you can tell, I'm a little bit more into the country side of things, but I really have enjoyed playing in this band and playing this style of music and hearing everybody do it. It's a real joy, and I'm in the right spot for it. So,
yeah,
thank the program, everybody. Yeah, and I want to thank everybody that's here, taking time out of your busy week to come on down here and listen to us. And I want to thank everybody who's on Facebook Live right now. I want to thank you guys for tuning in.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, his mom. I hope you're doing well. I don't know how that sounded, but.
Just sing the song.
Alrighty. Yeah, I got important to sing the song, so this is Dooley, whenever you're ready.
Electric guitar in Woo! The country band.
Yeah!
So you're going to get to hear him tomorrow night with the country band first thing. And he's also playing, some of y'all probably remember Alexis Hamilton, who is a great songwriter. She just graduated from ETSU, and you're playing in her band now on electric guitar. So why the bass? How did that happen?
Well, my bad. Nate told me that we didn't have bass players, so that's what I've done this semester. Because the plan was to play mandolin, but then I met Mr. Troy Boone over there, and he kind of took it away from me a little bit there. Rightfully so, though, rightfully so. So I figured I'd learn how to play a little bit of the bass for y'all. Oh, okay, well, let's see, who's coming up next here? Go. Okay, what's the name of y'all playing?
Well, we need to talk a little bit more about Brittany here.
Oh, okay.
So, tell us about Brittany.
I don't know much about her now.
Tori Warren, everybody.
Thank you. Yeah.
Ooh, got a little 240 hertz ringing there.
Thank you.
Mm. Ben Bateson is here tonight, our recording lab manager. He's got students who are working the board back there. We really, I'd say, Ben has been here now 10 years, right? 11?
Almost 12.
Almost 12?
Yeah.
Man. Yeah, you started in 2010, right?
Yeah.
January of 2010. So, my gosh, man, time slips away. We have about a $750,000 state-of-the-art recording laboratory where students learn how to record, and it's really something special, and during the spring semester in particular, that facility will be booked 24 hours a day during the second half of the spring semester. Students will be doing projects in there at 4 o'clock in the morning on Saturday, so it's in that much demand. And we have a brand new audio production concentration and a minor on the horizon here. We also have a Scottish and Irish music concentration and minor. We have an old-time music concentration and minor. We have bluegrass music profession major concentration now. So these are all new developments, things that are moving our program forward. And again, one of the best things that we have this year are our artists-in-residence, and our other artists-in-residence tonight comes to us from many different locations, actually. You're not from any one particular location, are you? I mean, California recently, and Nashville, but where? You've played a lot of places, right? Lived a lot of places.
Yeah, I grew up in California, in the Bay Area. So, yeah. But now I live in Tennessee. And I really like it here.
Yeah.
Especially right here. This place rules.
I want to encourage everybody, behind Crosby there is a sign-up sheet, a newsletter sign-up sheet. If you want to get on the email list for the Down Home and find out when events are happening here, please go back to the bar and sign your names and put your email address. You get the monthly newsletter. And Keegan will help you with that. Keegan's wearing an ugly sweater tonight. Keegan Lucky Smith, serving the bar. And lady down front said, yes, it's very ugly, Keegan. That's true. We don't lie around here. Thank you, Reva and Keegan, for helping tonight. But anyhow, Brittany is here as our second artist in residence. And what a delight it's been to have her here teaching all of our students. This is the last group of the evening. Tell us what your names are.
I mean, collectively.
Yeah, we'll get to the individual people that you have here. You might know them already, but we are called Boom Chuck Chuck Chuck. Boom Chuck Chuck Chuck. Yeah. It's kind of inspired by the Ryan Nickerson Old Time Guitar Workshop, where we learned a lot.
Boom Chuck Chuck Chuck. Folks, make them feel welcome, and we will see you tomorrow night right here at the Down Home. Brittany Haas, how are you?
fabulous fiddler Lillian Chase. On this next number, this is one she actually learned for another class, the Art of Interpretation class that I've been teaching with Roy. And it's just such an awesome tune that she worked up, so we wanted to do it in the band. It's called The Brilliancy Medley from Eck Robertson. This medley is that both of these fiddlers are from Grayson County, Virginia, my home state. Yeah. But it's cool that Colin and I have totally different backgrounds with music and different relationships to music, and we both found these two artists from the same place, and now we're kind of coming together. Yeah. So yeah. Colin, kick it off. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. we've introduced everybody in the band so far, but I don't think we've introduced Brittany yet. And it's been such a pleasure to work with her this semester. If you had told 16-year-old Lizzie that I would be standing on the stage of the Down Home with Brittany Haas, I wouldn't have believed you. I would have punched you in the face and called you a liar. But I think it's pretty awesome, and it's been such an incredible opportunity. So we're going to sing you one that comes from Burnett and Rutherford. It's All Night Long Blues.
Yeah.
Thank you.
What a great job. Everybody, thank you so much for coming out tonight. See us tomorrow night and the next night, if you would. Same time, same place. Thank you. Great job, everybody. One more round of applause for all our students here tonight. Thank you. Have a great evening.